Hello friends, a very good morning to all of you. I am Mainak from Civil Center and I welcome all of you back to our channel. So friends, in the previous video which we had uploaded in the previous morning, I had asked you some questions related to this site and I had also told you the advantages of backfilling using sand. So I had asked what are the errors which you observe in the reinforcement binding and any other problems which you observed in this site. So one user commented that the anchorage is not done properly. You can see that the development length has not been provided at the junction of the beams and columns. It should have been bent like this, anchored properly. So the anchorage has not been done. And also another user pointed out that the stirrup spacing are uniform, which should be lesser at the center, which should have been lesser near the supports and more at the center, but here they have provided uniform spacing for all the stirrups, which is absolutely wrong. So this is the two mistakes which our users pointed out. So I congratulate them for the discussion and for enhancing our knowledge. Another problem which we observe in this site is that the stirrups are not bent properly. You can see that they are bent at 90 degrees and not at 135 degrees. So this is another error which the contractor has done due to negligence. Another problem which we can observe in the site is that, as I had told, the advantages of backfilling using sand. What they have done is, without compacting the sand properly, without damping and compacting the sand properly, they have started binding the reinforcement for the plinth beam. And they are also intending, you see that their shuttering material or formwork material, they have already brought the shuttering material. They are intending to give the plinth level even before compacting the sand. So as I told in the previous video, the importance of sand in backfilling. First, we should dampen the sand properly using the potter pipes and then compact it. And after it gets compacted fully, then only we should go for the casting of the plinth level or other works. But if we go for the casting of the plinth level even before compacting the sand, then it will result in damage or disaster. Because after some time the floor will settle down, and if differential settlement occurs, and then we can cause cracks in the structure. So the use of this sand filling will not be of any use in that case. So most of the people, what they do is they think if I could bring good quality material in the site, then the quality of work will be good. But this is not the case always. If they do some errors in the basic procedures of construction, then quality cannot be maintained. That's why I always say that hire a good consultant who can supervise your works. Don't give your work to any of uneducated or less educated contractors or even it's not about education as well, it's about cheating on the customers. These basic things, if they mistake, even if you give them proper amount, if we do mistakes in these basic things, this is definitely not acceptable. Because everyone makes house once or twice in a lifetime, and as a civil engineer we should make sure that we educate people on this. And to all the friends who are watching our channel, I request them, if you find any other mistakes at this site or if you face any problems at your site, you can discuss. This is an open platform. Also, we have a WhatsApp group for sharing knowledge related to civil engineering. If you are interested to join that, you can comment below. We'll definitely join you to that group. And if you find any other mistakes which you had observed in this site, you can let us know. Another thing I want to discuss is that you can see that this is the formwork material which they have used at this site. You see its quality. If you use such quality of formwork, then what will happen is that they will absorb the concrete. These are wooden pattas or wooden planks and very bad quality. So they will absorb the concrete and the concrete may also leak out. Then if we use M20, M25, whatever grade we are using, the quality will not be maintained because they will absorb most of the things. We can use steel formwork, we can use plywood, but these wooden planks or wooden pattas are definitely not acceptable. But most of the clients nowadays, what they do is they go to a contractor and ask the rates. What is your rate for construction per square feet? Say 1300, 1400, 800 for core house, 900. They only ask the rates. They don't go for the quality. So we should assure the quality of this. So we should assure the quality of our works as well before hiring a contractor. That's why I say that know your contractor and stay educated and keep watching our channel for more such videos. And do comment below your feedback and do comment below watch more videos you want to watch. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.